Everyone, welcome to you. I'm Hayley Palmer. It's so good to have you here with me on tonight's show, especially as we are joined by Glenn and Martha, who play Strat and Raven in Bat Out of Hell, the musical. And here is what happened when I caught up with Glenn. Glenn, it is so great to have you here on the show. How are you?
Oh, very well, thank you. It's lovely to be here. Thank you.
It's a real pleasure. I came to the press night of Bat Out of Hell. I actually sent you a message afterwards and I was like, you're an absolute star. Come on the show. So it's a real honour to have you here.
Oh, thank you very much. No, your words meant loads to me, so thank you very much.
And how's it all going? Because I know you've just come off stage. You're going back on stage in a minute. How do you do it?
A lot of chocolate, a lot of tea, a lot of caffeine.
Yes.
I mean, when it's music...
Sounds like my daily diet.
Yeah, mine too now. When it's music that's this amazing, it's no hardship, I promise. I thank my lucky stars every day that I get to go out and sing it, so...
We love that. And we're going to kick off with Bat Out of Hell. Now, this is a marathon song. You're kind of like jumping on bikes, jumping through fire. There's a lot going on. How do you get the stamina? I mean, I believe it's 8.5 minutes. Is that right?
It is, yeah, which is testament to what meat stamina was. I think people didn't really realise, but it is a marathon. We literally call it that. And yeah, in the show, there's blood, there's fire, there's confetti, there's everything. So yeah, it really is.
Night out.
Yes, it's a challenge. The blood that we use in the show tastes amazing, so you'll know that when I sort of when I need the energy here, I just shove a load of it in my mouth and swallow it because it's so sweet.
Wow, love that. And do you ever just go halfway through, or do you know what, I think I need to go and have a little bit of a sit down, or are you like so psyched up in your head that you're just like, you're on a mission?
You get riled up for it, and the audience as well, you feel this like palpable energy that they're with you on it, and you can hear someone usually singing along, and that keeps me going. I can do it for them.
That's so true, Glenn, because when I was sat there, I did notice like a real energy in the audience, and you don't always get that when you see things, but also in the interval as well, everyone was like, wow, that was amazing. You could see it was just giving people so much energy, because it's like one big party. It's a great night out, isn't it?
A really great night out. Loads of people will say to me all the time that they feel like for those 2 hours that they're 18 again. And I love that. I think, yeah, that's what we want. Like, that's priceless, right?
Right. So we are going to go back to being 18 years old, back in the good old days, and check out Bat Out of Hell. And I will be talking to the brilliant Glenn Adamson on the other side of this. Now, I want to rewind how everything started for you. How did you get this phenomenal voice? Like, where did you get your talent from? Is it natural, or have you had to work at it?
A mix of both. I mean, started really young singing sort of music like this with my family when I was growing up. I would always sort of get on the karaoke's, and as a small child, my dad would sort of march me from karaoke bar to karaoke bar, so it was always sort of there. And then I would do like Battle of the Bands at school, things like that got me sort of some rocky roots. And then I went away to drama school to do an acting degree, but it was Paul McCartney's school in Liverpool, Lipper.
Oh, yeah,
and
Lipper,
so there was that Beatles route. There was that Beatles route the whole time. You were listening to this great music and you go to the Cavern Club, and that was sort of bleeding into the acting as well at the same time. So it sort of felt natural after that I would sort of push in this rocky acting direction. And then my career's just gone that way ever since, yeah.
Yeah, I was going to say, because you starred in American Idiot. How was that?
Yeah, amazing. I mean, Green Day was one of my favourite bands growing up. You know, I used to listen to this music, Green Day growing up, Bon Jovi. So I keep just waiting for the Bon Jovi bit to be the next one.
Oh, I love a bit of Bon Jovi. Living on a Prayer.
Yeah, me too. Yeah.
What a song. But I mean, do you think you'd ever go into something completely different? Do you think one day you're going to go, actually, no more rock musicals, I'm going to go completely something... you just wouldn't imagine. Do you think that would happen?
Yeah, I mean, who knows? Never say never. Though me and Martha do have a joke where I always say that the answer to I would do anything for love but I won't do that is I would do anything for love but I won't do lamers is my running joke.
But is there a musical that you've got yourself, like, set your eyes on in London? Is there anything...
Do It would sort of be for me anything that's like, you know, there's a running theme, Rock of Ages, We Will Rock You, School of Rock, mm-hmm. any of those. They're mm-hmm. sort of the shows that get me going that I'm excited by, yeah.
Yeah, watch this space. Well, I want to talk about your tour. You're going over the UK. You're actually going to my hometown, the Mayflower Theatre, on the 28th of June. Got to get a little plug in there for my hometown. I mean, just incredible that you get to go all over. What is tour life like?
It's amazing. I mean, Southampton, the Mayflower, like you talk about, I love that theatre. I think it's so, ooh, it's so beautiful, stage. One of the most yeah. beautiful theatres. Do you know what? It's great seeing how every city reacts to the show differently. It plays so different everywhere, and I love that. The more north you get, the more rowdy the crowds.
Is
absolutely.
Is that right? I need to be up north then.
When it's in Scotland, yeah. It absolutely goes off. There and just cities that you think of as being so musical, like Liverpool or Sheffield, somewhere like that, when you go there you really do feel this like love for music in the city when you take a show like this that's music based. So that's amazing. You know, you don't obviously with London, it's an amazing city, a lot of the shows are tourists that come to see it, whereas when we're travelling to you, we're really getting the locals and you get a really good taste of what local
life is
like.
Yeah, the local diehards, yeah.
Yeah, which is amazing.
Yeah, absolutely.
Love that.
It is. Well, we're going to put details on the screen below of where the tour is going to and how you can get tickets. And we're going to play out Meatloaf, I Would Do Anything For Love, and I'll catch up with Glenn after this. Great. Now, we have got a quick fire question round for you, Glenn, because we'd like to get to know our guests a little bit more. Are you ready?
Hit me.
Okay, ritual before you go on stage. Please say it's rock and roll.
Do you know what? It's an Elvish trick. It's tea with homemade honey in it. So my auntie has bees, so she gives me the honey. You have a cup of tea and a massive wobble, which people think is not rock and roll, but I'm like, if it's good enough for Elvis, it's good enough for me.
Exactly. And you know where you are with a cup of tea, don't you? You know,
you
good
do,
cup
yeah,
of tea.
Yeah.
It's actually good, doesn't it? So make sure you have one before you go on stage in a minute. Favourite song in the show, putting you on the spot now, but is there one that you just go, yes, this is my fave, I love it?
Anything for Love. I'd do anything for love. Every time. Yeah, I love the audience vibe and I love singing it. Yeah, it's my favourite.
I love singing it and I'm just so tone deaf, it's not good, but I was that person in the audience that was singing it full blast, which I know they ask you at the beginning not to sing, don't they? They say to the audience, no, save it. So I do apologise there for the singing on my behalf. Funniest thing that's happened on stage?
Do you know what? The other day me and Martha got, I wear chains on my jeans and me and Martha got conjoined by them. So we couldn't get apart for the whole of Anything for Love. So eventually we did, but Martha just had to walk around there hanging from her fishnets. But we were, it looked like I'd sort of taken her hostage.
I love that you completely starred it out there. You were just like, yeah, we're pros.
Yeah, we starred it out.
You prepared
for
everything.
I just dragged her around. She had no choice.
Oh, bless her. And is there a proud moment in your career? Is there some point that you just went, oh, wow, like, I'm proud of myself for getting this far. Is there one of those moments for you, Glenn?
I think when we took the show, we took Battle of Hell to do BBC's Big Night of the Musicals, and that was in an arena with 13,000 people, and that was phenomenal. The sound of those people reacting to Battle of Hell was once in a lifetime, yeah.
Yeah, and I was going to say to you, I mean, obviously we know about Meatloaf. How was that for you? I mean, it must have been a real shock.
Yeah, it was. It was a real shock and a real sadness, but then at the same time, it's amazing to do his music and his legacy. And I think for us, singing it now, it feels so much, it's so special now, knowing that his music is still out there and people listen to it and people are finding it now from the show, which means, you know, that it's not generational now. It's like it's living on. We're getting new fans of the music via the musical. So we love that and feel like we just want to do him justice, you know.
Well, you absolutely are. And like I say, my friends and I came tonight. We thought it was just wonderful. I know it got such a good reaction. And you're continuing to just wow crowds every night. So keep up the good work. Go and have your cup of tea and your honey and some chocolate. Go and get a Twix.
I will do.
And we can't wait to see what you do in the future, Glenn. But thank you so much. It's the brilliant Glenn Adamson, everyone.
Can you feel my heart?
Yes. Can you feel mine?
Yes. Raven, I want your heart to beat as fast as mine. I want to speed it up so that our bodies rhyme.
Is that your usual pickup line?
Ouch! 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 I know just how to whisper, and I know just how to cry.
I know just where to find the answers, and I know just how to lie.
I know just how to fake it, and I know just how to scheme.
I know just when to face the truth, and then I know just when to dream.
And I know just where to touch you, and I know just what to prove. I know when to pull you closer,
and I know when to let you loose.
And I know the night is fading, and I know the time's gonna fly. And I'm never gonna tell you everything I gotta tell you, but I know I gotta give it a try. But I don't know how to leave you,
and I'm never.
Out of nothing at all.
Every time I see you, all the rays of the sun are streaming through the waves in your hair. And every star in the sky is taking aim at your eyes like a spotlight.
The beating of my heart is a drum, and it's lost, and it's looking for a rhythm like you.
You can take the darkness from the pit of the night and turn into a beacon burning endlessly bright. I gotta follow it, cause everything I know, well, it's nothing till I give it to you.
Making love.
It's now time to catch up with Martha Kirby, who plays Raven in Bat Out of Hell, the musical. Enjoy. Martha, it's great to have you here on the show. How are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you?
I'm really well, thank you. And I have to say, I came to see the press night of Bat Out of Hell. I absolutely fell in love with it, and I thought I have to get you guys on the show. How's it going your end?
Yeah, it's going really well. We've actually just finished the Saturday matinee, so we're feeling good.
I don't know how you do it, Martha. You must be exhausted. I need like a cup of tea and biscuits and have a little cat nap before the evening.
You do. I have to have a little power nap. Lots of good food, lots of sugar, and you're good. You're good to go.
Yeah, good to go. Well, we're going to go and have a little look at your rehearsal footage for Crying Out Loud. Was it right that you actually did this in your audition with Glenn?
Yeah, it's the first time I actually met Glenn. We hadn't been in a room with each other until singing this song. So yeah, it was such a fun moment. Yeah.
Yeah, and you guys have just such great chemistry. What's it like working with each other?
Oh, it's wicked. We're kind of almost like brother and sister off stage, which makes it weird then on stage.
Oh, I love it. Well, we're going to have a little exclusive clip of this, and then I will be catching up with Martha on the other side.
I was lost till you were found, and I never knew how far down I was falling before I reached the bottom. And I was cold. And I never knew how the pyre could be burning on the edge of the ice field. Now the chilly California wind is blowing down our bodies again, and we're sinking deeper and deeper in the chilly California sand. Oh, I know. Bursting apart.
never knew how too late I was kneeling in the chains of my master. I could laugh over you.
Now, I want to rewind, Martha, how everything started for you, because you have this phenomenal talent. Have you always been able to sing, act and dance? Because I know you went to Guildford School of Acting, didn't you?
Yeah, it's something I've had. It's been like a passion of mine since I was a kid. And my grandparents and family always used to like take me to the Bristol Hippodrome when I was a kid. And it was like the biggest day out for me. I would just be so excited for it. And I think ever since then, I just thought, you know, that's what I'd like to do, and I've been very fortunate and very lucky to be where I am.
I mean, you came out of Guildford School of Acting, then went into playing Sandy from Greece. How was that?
Oh, it was so much fun. I felt like I was just a like wide-eyed naive child going into this industry, but I've like made the best friends and had an incredible time.
Yeah, just wonderful. And I see that you were on Big Nights of Musicals. What was that like filming that?
Terrifying. It was massive. It was so scary, but to have Glenn and the whole company there with us and the team was so reassuring and calming. And it was, honestly, it was colossal. It was incredible.
Wow, yeah, that was absolutely fantastic. And we're going to have a look now at a rock and roll sit pro, which I believe is the first time the cast and the band come together in rehearsals. What was that like, Martha? Talk us through those days.
Oh, it was amazing. We had a full day of rehearsal before the sit pro, and then we went in, and it was the first time we've heard the whole band together. And when you hear the music, I mean, you'll know yourself, it's just epic. So to be in the room and hear the drums, the guitars, the pianos, just the sound, the massive sound was just phenomenal. Yeah.
It's just goosebumps, isn't it? And when I came to see the show, I thought, Hayley, do not sing full blast. I just wanted to like break out into the song. And I was like, no, we're going to hold it to the finale. You know, it's quite hard because it's just so exciting. It's like one big party. So for anyone that hasn't seen it, make sure you book your tickets. We're going to put details on the screen below. Check this out and we'll see you after.
Like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone when the morning comes. But when the night is over, like a bat out of hell, I'll be gone, gone, gone. No, I won't do that.
I know the territory I've been around. It'll all turn to dust and we'll all fall down. Sooner or later, you'll be screwing around.
I won't do that. No, I won't
I would do
that.
Anything for love. Oh, I would do anything for love. I would do anything for love. But I won't do that.
No, I won't do
question from one of our lovely viewers, Caitlin, who says, what's your favourite scene from Batter of Hell?
My favourite scene would be the birthday party scene, just because I find it hilarious trying to see if Rob is going to actually sit down on his chair and if it's not, he's not going to fall on his bum. So it's always filled with excitement for me.
Yeah, what's going to happen? And for me, When you sang It's All Coming Back to Me Now, I was like, hang on a minute, this girl can sing. Wow, you're just incredible. Like, how do you even do that? Because I'm tone deaf, Martha. I don't understand.
lots of practice and lots of good singing teachers and guidance. I owe everything to my teachers.
What, from Guildford School of Acting?
Yeah. Oh. And before, before then.
Yes. Exactly, you're grateful for everyone that's helped you on your journey. Yeah. Well, I just think that you are doing a phenomenal job. You're absolutely made for the role. And like I say, I do urge everyone to come and see it because I was just telling everyone, I'm like, go and see Better Out of Hell, anyone that will listen. Come on, everyone get down there and see it. I know you're going on tour, which is really exciting. So we will keep everyone posted. But thank you so much for giving up your time. I know you've come off stage, you're going back on stage. Absolutely incredible. Thank you, Martha.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
It's Martha Kirby, everyone, from Better Out of Hell.
Hello, Wimbledon! There is no doubt that you all know that we lost a very, very dear friend last night.
He was a man with a big heart, a bigger personality, and the iconic voice that made Jim Steinman's music fly.
He was a huge inspiration to Jim, a huge inspiration to this show. And a huge inspiration to all of you and all of us.
Tonight's show we've dedicated to his honor, and we promise you, meet wherever you are, that we are going to keep the flame of rock and roll burning.
So we invite you all to take out your phones if you don't have them out. Turn on a light and raise your horns, because Meatloaf, we love you. And may the beat be yours forever.
You can run away forever, but there's nothing wrong with getting a good head start.
You want a shot? Shut down the sun.
You wanna shut away the pieces of your broken heart.
Think of how we lay down together. We'd be listening to the radio so loud and so strong. Every golden nugget coming like a gift of the gods. Someone must have blessed us when they gave us some song.
Martha and Glenn for being just wonderful on tonight's show, and thank you to you at home for supporting the show. It really is much appreciated. We're going to leave you with some more Meatloaf, and I will see you same time, same place next week.
Yeah, I'm sure I get the money.